As you know, I'm super hyped for the Steam Deck. I'm a big fan of PC gaming, portables, and APUs in general. So when they announced the Steam Deck, I had a lot to say about it. I did two big live streams back to back on my channel, so make sure to go and check out those videos. Now, I know they're a bit long, but I went through and did timestamps of everything, so you can go through, browse the topics you want to watch, and watch it that way, and I'll leave links in the description below. Okay, so what I want to do in this video is talk about one aspect of the Steam Deck, probably the most important aspect of all, which is the processor or the APU. Now, it looks like it's a custom chip developed specifically for the Steam Deck, possibly the AMD APU codenamed Van Gogh. Now, the question I want to answer is, what is the likely performance of this RDNA2-based GPU, and can we compare it to any of the other existing APUs out there at the moment, such as the Renoir or Cezanne APUs, as well as the VEGA and Navi GPUs out there as well? Okay, so if you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this, and we have a Discord server, so come along and join us there, and I'll leave a link in the description below. So these are the specs of the Steam Deck, and we're going to focus on the APU, and if people are interested, I like to do videos of the LPDDR5 RAM and also the eMMC and SSD storage as well. An APU, which is the accelerated processing unit, is basically the CPU and GPU processor combined along with any other necessary functions that may be needed to have a complete system on chip solution. For example, this Renoir Ryzen 4000 series APU has a Zen 2 CPU and a Vega GPU on the one chip, tied together with Infinity Fabric and a range of multimedia engines and other input-output functions. Another example would be the Xbox Series X APU, though this would be quite different to the Steam Deck APU we're talking about. The GPU is far stronger, and that would require a lot more power to fully utilize. The Steam Deck CPU component is a Zen 2 4-core 8-thread CPU. In terms of performance, I think this is the right fit for Steam Deck. Some people may expect a minimum of 6 to 8 cores these days, but given that portable gaming machines are fairly restricted in terms of battery life, size of the portable, and the heat it generates, I think Valve found a good balance with the number of cores and threads in the CPU. Generally speaking, at such low power, such as 4 to 15 watts, games will most likely be GPU limited, even going forward. This is something you can check benchmarks and see for yourself how a 4-core 8-thread CPU runs for mobile GPUs. I want to spend the bulk of the video on the GPU, and the tech specs state that the GPU here is 8 RDNA2 compute units running between 1 GHz and 1.6 GHz. The power window is between 4 watts and 15 watts, and my guess is that on the Steam Deck, 15 watts is probably locked, which was how the GPD Win 2 turned out, which was a system I had for a while. 15 watts, according to the tech specs, gives around 2 hours of gaming time, so more power is probably not useful above this anyway. I have a feeling AMD will probably lock this down to 15 watts and below, despite RDNA2 on desktop clocking pretty high to 2.5 GHz and above, mostly because this is a mainstream handheld and the cooling solution is pretty much fixed for everyone. I think many people are going to enjoy running this system at 4 watts and getting anywhere between 6 to 8 hours of portable gaming and not running anything too graphically demanding. It's just my opinion, but graphically less demanding games are just going to run closer to their desktop counterparts and you won't feel like you're missing too much of the experience. We have one clue about the graphical performance of the Steam Deck. The specs here say that 8 RDNA2 compute units deliver 1.6 teraflops of compute power. And I think the question on everyone's minds is how much this is and can we compare it to other existing GPUs? The closest comparison, in my opinion, is the Renoir and Cezanne APUs that you can see on this AMD processor roadmap. They both use 8 Vega compute units. The difference is that the Renoir APU uses the Zen 2 CPU and Cezanne APU uses Zen 3. But GPU-wise, they should be pretty close, give or take any minor frequency differences between models. According to the Ultrabook website, the Ryzen 4800U, a Renoir APU with 8 Vega compute units, is listed at 1.8 teraflops, and the Ryzen 4700U with 7 Vega compute units is listed at 1.5 teraflops. Does this mean 8 Vega compute units beats out 8 RDNA2 compute units? Probably not. As you know, even though teraflops is a measure of compute power, teraflop measurements between architectures doesn't always directly translate into final performance. Vega is just one of the GPUs built on AMD's previous architecture, GCN, Graphics Core Next. And after going through their RDNA whitepaper and presentation, there are many changes and increase in performance. And comparing the Vega 56 with 10.5 teraflops and the 5700 XT on RDNA architecture with 9.75 teraflops, performance benchmarks will tell you that the 5700 XT outperforms in actual performance by about 22% with a straight comparison. So my gut feel is that we will see 8 RDNA 2 compute units outperform 8 Vega units by about 20-30%, though of course this could vary on many other factors too, like the LPDDR5 RAM, the clock speeds of the GPU, and even how RDNA 2 performs in mobile processors. So nothing is certain at this stage, because this will be the first RDNA 2 APU available. But I think this does give some hope that RDNA 2 will improve GPU performance, where we've been stuck on Vega for a while now. Now, I did recall saying in the live stream that it could be close, but that was only because I was basing my opinion off the teraflop numbers, so I do want to correct that point. Let's dive further into the GCN versus RDNA comparison, and a few years ago, Digital Foundry did a piece trying to compare the architectural performance difference, despite not actually having equivalent hardware. Their main goal here was to compare GCN 1.0 architecture versus RDNA 1.0 architecture and see what the performance difference was between an equivalent teraflop. Digital Foundry couldn't directly compare the R9 280X versus the RX 5700, so they added a between step to Polaris cards, the RX 570 and the RX 580. While these cards aren't Vega, which was GCN 5.0, I think this does give a decent insight into the performance gain for an equivalent teraflop. To do this, they underclocked the clock frequencies to 1 GHz on all cards and adjusted memory bandwidth to 256 GB per second. Theoretically, this adjusted the cards to 4.1 teraflops for the R9 280X and RX 570 and 4.6 teraflops for the RX 580 and RX 5700. I'll leave a link below for the very detailed article, but we'll just jump straight to the conclusion. And based on the actual performance found in games, at the same 4.6 teraflops, there was a 27% gain between GCN 4.0 and RDNA 1.0. In Crysis 3, it was 22% between these architectures. While Vega is probably less than this given its GCN 5.0, it shouldn't be far off. Of course, final performance is going to vary greatly, depending on RAM speed, clock frequencies, but hopefully Valve manages to maximize and balance hardware requirements to get as much performance as possible. Also, as a quick note, while we've mostly looked at RDNA 1 GPUs, RDNA 2 should be equivalent or better. While there are many changes as listed on their AMD website, the main differences are that it has ray tracing, which will unlikely be used given most users will be after performance, and Infinity Cache, which is an unknown at this point anyway. Finally, let's take a quick look at what you might expect in terms of gaming performance on the Steam Deck. This is a video benchmark of Control running on a Ryzen 4700U, which has 7 Vega units. Currently, this is running at 720p low settings at 25fps. With 8 Vega units, theoretically this should give you another 12% performance, giving 28fps, and another 20% performance due to RDNA 2 takes you to 33fps. This isn't anything earth-shattering, but 30% extra performance in low-power situations is much needed. So to summarize, based on the research around the web, at equivalent teraflops, the RDNA 2-based GPU should outperform the Vega GPU by around 20%. But of course this depends on other variables as well in the Steam Deck, such as the LPDDR5 RAM and also final clock speeds of the CPU, GPU and memory. Okay, so that's it for this one. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this, and I'll see you in the next one.